Welcome! Today we will be talking about the difference between absolute and incremental encoder. Before starting, let's quickly review what an encoder is. Most of the motors, if we apply the power, it spins, but there is no feedback to let you know what is the speed of the motor or how many times its shaft has been rotated or what's the position it ended up in. We can integrate an encoder with the motor to provide that feedback. Using the various methods, it measures how much the shaft is rotated and sends this information to the PLC controller. In an incremental encoder, output typically have two square waves on the individual output channels that are 90 degrees out of phase to each other, with the two output square waves offset to each other by the 90 degrees. As the encoder rotates, it's possible to calculate which direction the shaft is moving by looking at the order of the incoming signal state change. These signals can be used to measure the speed of rotation and the distance traveled. With little math, it's even possible to calculate the angular position of the shaft. Now, while the information provided by the incremental encoder is incredibly useful, there are some drawbacks due to the fact that they only measure the relative movements. They provide information if there is a moment, and if there is a power law, for whatever reason, the current position becomes unknown. They also require constant monitoring. If there is a noise in the system or the encoder pulse is missed, then we have to reset the encoder reading to reconcile with the machine operation using an index pulse. However, all of these drawbacks are overcome using an absolute encoder. It uses optical, magnetic, or capacitive sensors to identify the unique position within a motor revolution. With optical encoders, as soon as you switch on an encoder, it knows exactly what the position of the shaft is and will transmit the data digitally to the PLC, usually over a Profibus interface, without needing to rotate the shaft. Instead of simply counting how far you are moving in one direction or the other in the incremental encoder, the absolute encoder knows its current position at all times. From this, speed, rotation, and direction can easily be derived. There are both single and multi-turn absolute encoder available. Multi-turn encoder not only gives you the absolute position of the motor shaft, but also actively track the number of rotations the motor has made. The resolution of these encoders is usually specified as the number of binary bits available per turn. For instance, a 12-bit encoder would have 4096 unique positions, similar to 4096 pulses per revolution in the incremental encoder, as discussed in the previous video. The difference, though, is that the positions of the absolute encoders are each unique, and with a simple calculation, you can convert the binary position value to an actual angle in degrees. Incremental encoders are slightly expensive and also requires the hardware and software processing to convert the pulses into some useful information. This adds more complexity as we combine the encoders in conjunction with each other. It's much easier to combine absolute encoder into the system with their various, as the price gap between absolute and incremental encoders is shrinking now. Absolute encoders are becoming more and more popular. Absolute encoders are used in robotics and camera motion control gimbals. So that's the end of today's video. Please do like, share, and subscribe this channel and press the bell icon to get the notification of our latest videos. Till next time, take care and goodbye.